बहुत प्यारे दंगल 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 सूरज तेरा चढ़ता ढलता गर्दिश में करते हैं तारे दंगल 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 दंगल. ग्रेट मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, मायसेल्फ भूपेश आनंद. आई एम अ क्वालिफाइड चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट. आई डिड सीए फ्रॉम इंडिया. आई डिड कंपनी सेक्रेटरी बोर्ड फ्रॉम इंडिया एंड आई डिड सीएमए फ्रॉम इंडिया एंड एज वेल एज आई डिड डिप्लोमा इन आईएफआरएस फ्रॉम लंडन, एजीसी लंडन. एंड आई एम स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू फॉर डिलीवरिंग लेक्चर नंबर 5. इट रिलेट्स टू मॉनिटरी एंड फिजिकल पॉलिसी. We have discussed what is the meaning of a monetary policy. We have discussed what is the meaning of a physical policy. And now, I am on to the most important lecture and a very small lecture, that is learning outcome number E. We have discussed this name so many times in different subjects. So the name is Irving Fisher. I will be doing Fisher's effect, that what is the meaning of a Fisher effect, what he wants to say. What is the nominal rate? What is the real rate? What is the inflation rate? We have discussed in so many other subjects as well. But still, I will be covering here because a separate learning outcome is devoted, is, you know, for this effect. So please take out your registers. No defeat is final. I have written for you. Quote of the day, quote of the class, quote of the lecture. No defeat is final until you stop trying. It means I cannot be defeated unless and until I have stopped trying. If I am ready for trying it again and again, again and again, again and again, I can assure you, you will get success. So let's start with this positive thoughts. Lecture number 5, monetary and physical policy. And today I will be discussing with learning outcome number E, describe the Fisher's effect. Fisher. The full name is Irving Fisher. I-R-V-I-N-G. Irving Fisher. He has devoted, you know, he has contributed so many different logics in currency exchange rates as well as in normal finance. So I will be discussing with Fisher's effect. Now, no doubt, I have not explained you what is the meaning of a Fisher. With the help of a simple case study, I will be telling you what I mean by Fisher's effect. But before that, you have to just write on 2 points. First point is Fisher effect states that what is the theory tells us. Irving Fisher states that the nominal interest rates, it means the interest which are existing in the market. It means the interest rate which we are being told by the banking people that they will be giving this much interest rate on bank FD. That is named as nominal interest rate. Nominal means prima facie, which we see on the documents. That is nominal interest rate. So Fisher effect states that nominal interest rates are sum of real interest rates and expected inflation. I repeat, all words are very, 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 very important. You know, I have not used the word inflation. Rather, I have used a prefix in that. Expected inflation. So, my dear friend, as per Irving Fisher, you know, the nominal interest rates are equal to real interest rates, in reality, how much true you are earning that interest. That is named as real plus expected inflation. So I will be discussing with that. No need to worry, just write in the formula. This is interest rate, nominal interest rate. It is sum total of real interest rate plus expected inflation. Now, why I am using expected inflation? Again, I will be telling you. So before that, just write on this formula. Nominal interest rate is equal to real interest rate plus expected inflation. And then Irving Fisher has modified his formula by giving a separate logic, and that is very valid logic. So firstly, note down that as per Irving Fisher, investors are exposed to the risk. As per Irving Fisher,
investors are exposed. Investors are exposed to the risk that inflation and other future outcomes may be different. You know, this is a valid point, which I will be telling you with the help of a case study, that there involves a risk also, because the word I have used here is expected. Expected means in the future, and the future is uncertain. There can be unforeseen events. If you're expecting this much as an inflation rate, it may be possible that interest rate can be more than that, or interest rate can be less than that, and there can be some unforeseen events in the future. So that risk factor is involved in that, and for that risk factor, that also, you know, for that risk factor, again, you have to contribute something, and that contribution is named as risk premium. So just see what I have written. As per Irving Fisher, investors are exposed to the risk. Now, which risk? Unforeseen risk, future risk, which can be there in the future due to any circumstances, and other future outcomes may be different than expected. They may be different than expected. So investors require additional return. So investors acquire or require additional return. So investors require additional return and risk premium. And risk premium and risk premium for bearing the risk, you know, because there is a risk involved in that in future those things which we have expected they will happen or not. So what are those things? We will discuss in that. So nominal interest rate will be equal to real interest rate plus expected inflation that we have already discussed, plus a new component named as risk premium for uncertainty. So please note down this formula. I am starting with the logic behind that how this formula has been derived, or what is the logic which Irving Fisher has stated in supplementing this formula, in complementing this formula. So for that, I will be taking an example of a case study. For example, Mr. Ram. He is Mr. Ram. Now he has $100 note with him. $100 US, and he has two choices. Again, I am repeating, very important case study. Please refer to it. See it carefully. Next 2 minutes are very important to understand the concept of Fisher's effect. The first point is, I told you, let it be Mr. Ram is there, and Mr. Ram has $100 of a currency note, and now that $100 currency note, he has two options. He has two options. Either he can watch a movie, a latest movie of Jackie Chan, and or he can invest that $100 for a year in bank FD, and after 1 year he will see that movie. He will sacrifice his consumption today. I am repeating it again. Mr. Ram has $100 with him in his pocket. He has two options. Option number one is he can spend $100 by watching a movie along with popcorn. He can enjoy that. And option number two is, instead of watching movie today, he's sacrificing his consumption for a year. And after 1 year, he will be watching that movie. Now, the point is, he will be getting 10% as interest rate per annum from that bank FD, Bank of America. We invest for 1 year. I am assuming that Bank of America is giving 10% per annum as an interest rate. It means after 1 year, he will be getting $110. So just see, after 1 year, he will be getting $110. But when after 1 year, he wants to go to that movie to watch that same movie, That cinema hall people, they are saying that now the same ticket will not cost you $100, but the actual cost has been increased due to inflation. They have increased the prices of per ticket, and let the rate be 8%. Let the inflation rate be 8%. Now they have increased their prices from $100 to $108. It means there is an increase in the prices by 8%. So $108 is the price of the same ticket. It means in actual, if he wants to see the movie after 1 year, he has to pay $108. It means he is having $110 in his pocket. He has to pay $108. It means he will be having $2 as a net saving, as a true saving, which will remain in his pocket. So I will say that $2 is the real income, real saving, which he will be having, you know, for sacrificing his consumption. So the same logic is being used by Fisher. So total saving, true saving of Mr. Ram will not be $10, rather it will be $2 because of inflation also. So $10 is the, I will say, nominal interest rate, $2 is the real interest rate, and $8 is inflation. And inflation plus real is equal to nominal. So like this, he has framed the formula. Nominal is equal to real plus inflation. And then, you know, then he has moved to a new concept, you know. So like this, we have seen that how this formula has been derived. Now, if I see, you know, the government bond yield returns, Indian government bond yield returns. So let's see, I want to give you some real aspect, real case studies. If you see that what are the rates, you know, in by government of India for the government bonds, what is the interest rate? Just see this, these are the rates. It means if you buy the security on 30th August 2018, then for 10 years, if you buy a 10-year government bond, you will be getting 7.93% as the return. And if you buy on 29th August, you will be getting 7.292% of interest. It means this much you will be getting by investing in the government security for 10 years. You're getting a point? So these are the rates. These are the nominal interest rates, I will say, because these have been given by government of India. Now if I see the inflation rate, you know, if I see the inflation rate, if I see, this is the historical India 10-year historical data. Just see, September 3, 2018, the interest rate is 7.923, then 7.951, then 7.930, then 7.895. It means it is in parallel to 7.98 or 8%, I can say. And if I see the inflation rates of India, you know, average inflation rates, now the average inflation rate comes out to be 4.35% for India. And if I am investing here in government security, I will be getting 7.93. It means 7.93 minus 4.35, I am getting 3.58. It means 3.58 is the real rate, 4.35 is the inflation rate, and the nominal rates are these. So on the basis of that, now you have to see that whether it is viable to invest in 10-year government security or not. You're getting a point. I want to tell you what is the meaning of a Fisher effect. When I say Fisher effect, it means nominal interest rates are equal to real interest rates plus inflation. Now this is the inflation, real inflation, which I am touching you, you know, I want to show you, because it will give you somewhat of perspective or relationship to understand the concepts. And if I see, you know, the Bloomberg, again the same rates are being shown, and just see the graph. They are showing us the graph. Now it has been decreased, you know, it has been decreasing. So the point is, the nominal interest rates are decreasing, and if the inflation is increasing, then real rate will decrease. So like this, I can easily find out whether to invest or not to invest. So once we have seen that nominal interest rates is equal to real interest rates plus inflation rates. Now this inflation rate is expected inflation rate. It means we are expecting that we will be getting this much. But because expectation is always in the future, and future is always uncertain, and it may happen that expected inflation rate is not equal to actual inflation rate in future. It means that it involves, this expectation involves some risk to it. Because of risk of unforeseen events, risk of not meeting the expected inflation target. And because of that risk, you know, this investor should be given some extra some extra, that is real interest rate plus expected inflation, because there is a risk involved in expected inflation. So some risk premium is also to be given. So the net formula, the last formula as per Irving-Fisher is nominal interest rate is equal to real interest rate plus inflation, expected inflation rate plus risk premium. You getting my point? So this is all which has been told by Irving Fisher. Be happy, be jolly, be cheerful.